Okay, we have so many questions. Oh boy, we have lots of questions. So
rattle away.
We will get going on those, try and get a few of them asked. Okay, let's see. Mm-hmm. For our first question, Lisa Menz asks, where do you purchase wafer paper? I know you said it, but let's explain.
Yeah, well, all the supplies that you're seeing me use on this particular piece, the colorants, the airbrush colors, the lusters, the wafer paper itself, were from Chef Rubber. They are one of the companies that I tell everybody enable me. In other words, they indulge my artistic eccentricities, and they give me products to see what I can do with, see what I can break a few rules with. So the cocoa butter color, everything is from them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Chef Rubber is great that way.
Yeah.
They're just so, I think they just love to see the art and the new, and they
yes.
want to be a part of that. So yeah.
Mm-hmm. They're very good at admiring and honoring the traditional techniques, the traditional work ethics, and at the same time, they're very proactive in championing new and innovative techniques. Again, humble, lowly wafer paper that's almost a throwaway, almost a necessary evil to have on the chocolate side, and all of a sudden you can do these things with it. That's what they wanted to see out of people. Yeah, that's mm-hmm. what they want to foster. So I'm very fortunate on that side.
That was great. Okay, let's see. Veronica mm-hmm. asks, can you dry brush it with petal dust or can you vodka plus petal dust to color it?
I have had students tell me that they can dry brush. It's not a technique that I use a whole lot of because I have my Grex airbrushes and I really like to airbrush. So I don't know how strong the color transfer would be, but I do know that it can be done. As far as mixing your petal dusts with vodka in painting, yes, it can be done, but I would restrict that to accent work because if you took a molded flower piece or a leaf and just dipped it into a vodka and petal dust mixture, it would just disintegrate. It would crumble and disintegrate because of the alcohol content.
Awesome. There are quite a few questions asking about the strength of this. You want to show them again what you did with that flower?
Sure. Okay, I'm going to move slow so the camera's not freaking out. Here's a flat 5 petal that was molded off of this mold.
I'm now touching. Okay, so it is flexible, but it is strong.
It is strong. I finally broke it. Okay. And that was with pushing it and pulling it back apart. It's not gummy at this stage, but it is pretty strong.
Okay. But if it's at a higher heat, it's more likely to be...
If it's at a higher... Yeah, the drier. It's not so much the heat, it's the dryness.
Dryness.
The drier it is, the more brittle it is. That's why I say this technique likes a little bit of humidity.
Okay, so if you're in a really dry place, you may have a little bit more of an issue with breakage.
Correct. Okay. Correct, but when you first airbrush, this is another reason to go with the airbrush route instead of the dry brush route, is when you airbrush, you're introducing a little bit of moisture to it. So if you airbrush and then assemble, everything's still just a little bit more flexible so that you can weight those two layers together until they glue. You can also... add a little bit of steam to a flower, a leaf base, if you want it to curl just a little bit. The wafer paper is stronger when it's molded than when it's flat. When it's flat, it's more porous. It has a grain to it, just like paper. But when it's molded and it has a chance to reform on that shape, you're using the engineering of that shape to impart structural strength. Just like in car and automotive making, you take a flat sheet of aluminum and you press mold it into the hood of a car. The hood of a car is going to be able to stand and bear a lot more weight and have a lot more engineering support structure to it than just a flat sheet.
Awesome. Okay, here's a quick one. Does it come in only white, or does it have to be colored? Does it come in colors?
It comes white because, again, this was originally designed to just be a support for nougats. I have seen people run the wafer paper through the edible inkjet. Machines. So you can print on it. Again, it's kind of soft. It's going to be a little bit more brittle because of the alcohol content in those inks. So you can do that. Now, whether or not you could take that printed edible ink sheet, cut it, dip it in water, and mold, I don't know. I haven't played with that. Somebody try it out and tell us.
Exactly. Okay. Let's see. Someone asks, can you attach floral wires to the petals?
Yes, absolutely. What I would do is push a wire up through, just bend a loop, and pull it back down so that you have a circle of wire on the top and your stem coming down the center. Then you can add your second layer, and your little wire bed is completely hidden. You have your wire coming down. That works quite well. You can take a leaf and attach wire, piping gel, and set the wire against the shape, let it dry in place. I would use the cloth wrap, the thread wrapped, because that gives the piping gel something to sink into, and it makes a better bond. If it's just the plastic coated stuff, it doesn't work as well.
Okay. And you'd probably want it to be pretty close to the same color that you're working with. So
right.
Either white, or if you're doing leaves, a green.
Right. And since you don't necessarily have to wire each and every leaf, you can get away from having to do the green floral wrap as much, so you can end up with a much lighter and much more refined wire stem than, again, traditional techniques. The little green leaves that would be on the bottom of the flower, again, those don't all have to be stemmed because they can be glued straight to the bottom of your flower base.
Perfect. All right, Debbie Beasley asks, and this will have to be our last question, I think, because we're running over a little. She says, if you overspray and the flowers or leaves become wet, where do you place them to let them dry without taking on another form?
Set them on a sill mat. If they go completely soggy flat, that's it. But if they're just a little softer than you want, just set them on a sill mat. And let them dry out until they get the level of softness that you want for working with. But again, because the wafer paper is so inexpensive, if something like that happens, just grab another one.
Awesome. All right, and here's a little bit of information on where you can find Lisa. We have one class that you have coming up at the Cake Cottage. That's there in San Diego. Well,
Marietta.
Yes, it's Marietta, which is close to San Diego.
Yes.
And then your website is battledress.biz.
Yes, there's a lot of body painting on there, and there's also pages for some of the culinary pieces, too.
Yes, I've actually been on your site. It's very cool stuff.
Hopefully it wasn't too scary for you.
There's some really interesting stuff on there, for sure.
Awesome. Yeah, I am a bit of an odd duck.
Well, a lot of cake decorators have the same type of interest, and so I think it would be fun for everyone
and
to go look at it.
If there are additional questions and they get routed to me, I'll be more than happy to answer them. I am on Facebook, and I can, again, it's ask away, because if one person has a question, that means 10 or 15 other people were thinking of it too. So
yes. Obviously. Okay, well, thank you so much, Lisa, for coming and joining us today. Thank you guys for listening. I apologize for my cold, and hopefully it'll all be gone by next week. I don't have this problem. So anyway, yeah, thank you so much, and I hope you guys enjoyed the training today, and we will see you next week. Bye.
Hey, did you like what you saw? Are you wanting to learn more? Then click on the link below or press the subscribe button to keep yourself up to date on everything that Cakefu has to offer. Because there's always something to learn in the world of cake decorating.